Pleasant good evening. Welcome into high school soccer right here on the IHSA TV network. Ron Pecorini, Rusty Silver on hand. The Class 1A state final right at the Corn Crib here in Normal. A bright and sunny late afternoon, early evening. 48 degrees, wind out of the northwest at about 13, gusting to 25 miles an hour. Could play some effects on tonight's championship game, but we're expecting a pretty good match. You look at these two teams, they match up very well. They're coming off some impressive semifinal victories for this championship.
Absolutely. I mean, not for anything. First thing I got to say, Rusty, this place is filled to the max right now. They must have bust in busloads for these teams, and it's great to see this both schools supporting it. And we are definitely going to see an interesting game tonight for the championship. It is windy. It is a little cold in my book, but I'm looking forward to getting this game started. I'm looking for some exciting things to happen, and congrats on both teams being here.
Waterloo Gibault from near St. Louis, southeast of St. Louis area, coming in with a record of 18-4-4, coached by Matt Reeve. Herscher, which is just in the area of Kankakee, a record of 23-4-1. Head coach is Alan High. Herscher wearing the white and the dark or black shorts with the dark numerals, and Waterloo Gibault wearing the all red, maroon, red, depends how you want to look at it, with the white numerals and red socks. And we're underway, and Waterloo Gibault will send the ball up. Both these teams had some big goals yesterday in both their contests. A few different ways of how they got the goals. Herscher might have found theirs in the second half. Two goals in a matter of less than, 48 seconds. And then Waterloo Gibault put together a nice run of goals themselves against a very good Francis Parker team, which put up six goals in the third place game.
Yeah, it was quite interesting how goals were scored yesterday for both these teams. But you know what? For whatever was yesterday's news, right now I am just so fired up to watch what's going to happen in this championship game. I can't really quite make a call for it. If you're just, kind of asking me which way do we go, I would think just after watching yesterday's game, I think maybe Gibault might be the team that might pull it off just by watching how things developed yesterday.
Yeah, the Waterloo Gibault Hawks, the ones to watch for, the red. A lot of good players on this team. Players that stood out for us yesterday, Mitch Meyer, wearing number 10. Also, number 13, Frank Mantilla. This is the man to watch out for. The guy here with 23 assists. And he got the ball right now, in fact. And the way he sets up the offense, he is really the workhorse, the guy that can set up the set pieces. And we were just amazed on his ability. In fact, we were talking about that earlier today. Well before today when we got to the stadium here, just how talented of an individual and a player that he is for this team.
He has got such a kick. I was telling you, I think he actually works on 10 yards, 20 yards, 30, 40-yard punts and chips because he just does it so good. He's a natural, yeah, but he definitely has to work on that. And kudos to him, because he hit his player every time yesterday. He got the ball where he had it to go, and it was a pleasure watching him. And I would have to say that's one of the reasons why he's got 23 assists.
In the box here, this ball is going to be picked up by the keeper, which is Leighton Howard, for the first save of the game. We'll talk about the keepers in a moment. I want to mention Taylor Enright. And also Andrew Reinholz, a couple guy, other guys to watch for up front for this Hawks team. And Reinholz had one of the goals yesterday off one of the setup crosses from a free kick that Mantilla had. And this one dropped in the middle, turn, fire, a shot. This will go wide and just past the post, right out of the reach of Howard. Good opportunity there.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Mitch Meyer, their team scorer with 17.
And another name I didn't mention is Wes Degener, who had a couple goals in the semifinal.
Yes, he had two yesterday. Yep. And matter of fact, you and I were talking, who would you give an MVP? And I think you were going West because he had two. And I said, well, I think it's all about how he got them. And I kind of went with Frank on this one.
Mm-hmm. Should mention Herscher, led by their speedy forward, Mitchell Schwarzkopf, number two. A lot of goals. He had a couple yesterday, didn't he, if I recall? And here's a guy that has really done wonders coming into the state tournament. 93 career goals, had 29 this year and 39 last year as a junior.
Yeah, I mean, he's just a goal scorer. He's a machine. He knows what has to be done. Incredible, career so far. 93 goals. And you know what? They're going to be looking for him today.
And right, had this go out. And a couple other players from Herscher we need to watch out for. Colin Lund up front, Nick Wheeler. Also another one wearing number 4 and number 6. Both players have had 11 goals coming into the state tournament. Sam Hall, who getting a start tonight, opposed to coming off the bench, he has 9 goals and 12 assists. And Travis Ostrowski, much as we talk about Mantilla, he came into this tournament with 20 assists.
Here's Mantilla right now doing his specialty corner kicks.
And this one going to float it up in the air. And right off the bat, Howard able to get to it and take his position and get the ball in a quick outlet.
Well, Howard stands at 6'3 as a goalie, so he's got a beautiful height to play the position. He has definitely got the moves for it. And Howard's got a .65 goal against average. He's only given up 17 goals in 26 games so far.
Frank Mantilla called for a foul, kind of reached out and grabbed the jersey of Mitchell Schwarzkopf. Nice little combination there. If these two get hooked up, can't say they know each other, but they're the best players of the teams here. Nice little hooking ball in, headed out. Good job there by Wes Degener helping out defensively. And this ball battle for a lot of numbers all bunched up here together in the middle of the field coming off that free kick. This one sent to the near side, a touch, and taking it forward. Good job there by Pakunas. Sent in the middle, head ball, loose, shot, put out off the post. What an opportunity. And Gregson had it in his hand, off the post, and came right back to him.
Fabulous save. Look at this, folks. I mean, just how the Hawks, beautiful. Number 3 looked like Jaeger Eriksson. And if the post wasn't there, it would have been off to the side. But what a beautiful save, really, by Austin Gregson. So we got a lot of action just starting up right off the bat.
Just about 6-7 minutes in this first half, and we got a whistle here. And this is going to be a free kick right side off the top of the box. And I mean right off the top of the box here.
That was close. Enright was making a move, and it looks like he was coming in so fast that he got a little bit of a push from the Hawk player. And they're calling it right at the 18 and a quarter.
Tigers set up a 3-man wall. Howard going to set it up. Mantilla is going to be taking this free kick. Watch for the corners. Mantilla sets him up. This one in the near side, and he was looking near post around the wall.
That was sweet, boy, I tell you. I'd be nervous as a goalie having Frank taking shots at me.
Well, where would you go on this? I mean, he's looking fireballs.
He was right. He was perfect. I'm telling you. Everyone thinks as a righty booter, that ball's going to hook always to your left. And he definitely caught Howard off on that one. Unfortunately, he was about 3-4 inches off from the right side of the post. But it would have been sweet. He definitely – this kid knows what to do with a ball. He's got it.
Battle on the far side. It goes out. It'll be – given to the Waterloo Gibault, thrown in down the line, and this ball will go out right off the body there of Mitch Meyer. Throw in now for the Tigers. Got a feeling we're going to see a big battle here with opportunities, and whoever can seize the opportunity and score here will make a difference in this game.
Yeah, I expect a low-scoring game, to be honest with you. I really do. Both keepers, I like both keepers, and both keepers have got some impressive numbers.
There's scoring potential out here on both sides.
Yeah,
we'll see as this develops here in this first half.
Gregson,
Schwarzkopf with a run here, getting pushed off the play. He's still battling for it, and good job here with Schwarzkopf.
Yeah, Gregson during the season, Rusty, has 148 saves. a .88 average, where Howard has 109 saves with a .65. That tells me not only you got goalie power here, you've got two very good defensive teams.
Degener, this one goes off to the far side, and Chase Meyer, closely guarded there, taking a make move towards the line, trying to get around this one, touched and bumped, and will roll out, and this will be, is it a throw or is it going to be a corner here? I think it's going to be a throw. Tyler Enright will come over and throw it in. A little late day sunshine here. We've had an afternoon of mainly cloudy skies with some breaks. It's getting a little brighter, but it's gotten a little colder out there. Long, high arcing throw, bouncing up in the air. Howard able to use his height to his advantage and bring it down.
Well, that high he has, 6'3".
Howard with a long kick. Wind will favor Herscher here in the first half. And we got a little bit of a grab on the jersey and a hold. This will be a free kick. So wind should favor a little more. The team's going north to south. In this case, Waterloo Gibault will have the opportunity with the wind. A little short kick here. Come up on the right side. This one kicked in, going wide of the post. I'd say Herscher yesterday in their semifinal, they really were on the downside. They were down 1-0, and then everything changed in the second half, courtesy of a lofted ball right off the kickoff to start the second half. It was a touch and then a long kick, and really caught the Genoa Kingston keeper off guard. He just wasn't ready for it, and
that
really
changed the momentum
everything
of the entire game.
And who knows what Herscher has, and especially with Coach Allen High to start in this game here.
Well, you got right now Gibault with head coach Matt Reb. Only 3 years in, 40 wins, 20 losses, and 8 saves.
And he took over for an awfully good longtime coach that led the program here for Waterloo Gibault. And that was Jim Corsi, a number of state championships, three of them in 05, 06, 07, but other places back in 01, a third, 02, a fourth. And of course, he also in 08 had a third, and 09 with a second place. So a lot of tradition here for this program. There's a move down the far side, outside the box, trying to make a move, will be kicked out right off the leg there of Wes Degener. Wes Degener, one thing I've noticed, he can play up and he can play back.
Yeah, he's definitely a two-way player, which you need. You definitely need players like that. And most teams need players like that.
Long throw in the box.
Actually, it's the best way.
This one loose and will be kicked out. It'll be a corner kick. A lot of the Hawks players were trying to make a run like it was going to be a goal kick, and they were caught off guard a little bit. Sam Pekunis will come over. He had one of the goals in the semifinal. He's going to kick this right in the sun. What's left of the angling sun here late in the day, or in the evening here. This one in the air, and will be headed out, now sent back in. And oh, an opportunity, maybe, as a chance was there to go after it. For Brody Ryan, he basically made a move one way and the ball went the other, and if he would have kept going, he might have had a chance for it.
Yeah, definitely on the back door. Even if Ryan was just two steps more, he could have just slid in and put that ball in.
This one out to the far side in chase and kicked out. Tom Francescon, one of the defenders, 6'2". A senior for the Hawks. A little bit of a battle. Herscher trying to go forward, now sent back the other way. A little slip on the turf. And this one kicked back the other way for Herscher. Sempakunis, now it's down the line. And this one kicked away. Nice job to knock it away. Here come the Hawks here on the far side. Able to send it to the middle. Degner. Degner trying to send it back to the box area. That was knocked away. Good job by the defense for the Tigers. About 14 minutes into the first half. And it's a battle already between these two teams. A couple of chances each way, early going, but keepers have stepped in and it's starting to be settling down now where the midfield is taken over on both sides. Where you think you're going one way and they stop you going the other.
Well, right now it's still very defensive. Both teams are trying to get their offense going, trying to make those passes, see where it's happening. But it's more of a defensive ball game right now.
Well sent down, cleared away. Good job by Ethan Shields, a junior. Ball thrown in. Dustin Love now sent down. Colin Lund kicked away. Herscher trying to get some forward attack here, but it goes back the other way. Now going forward, this one sent beyond the reach, a little bit too far. This one stopped and will be taken forward here by Ethan Shields. Shields pass off to the wing side.
Enright.
Over Enright there. Enright trying to take a move. Looking now, wants to take the line. Down the flank and across it. Into the middle. Dangerous spot. Coming over
Here's
to the
Frank
side.
Mischia.
Oh, and I'll tell you, the opportunity was there. Definitely for Frank Mantilla. I was just going to say, he's been quiet for the last 10 minutes. They've got somebody marking him, and next thing you know, he comes up with the opportunity here with the left foot.
Yep, and it's funny to say, some guys out there don't even touch the ball the entire game, and here you were talking about Frank about 10 minutes. It just goes to show how much he is part of that team. He makes things happen. You're always expecting Frank to be around the ball.
So midfield touched, yeah. And not a good kick here. Hawks going to bring it back. Mantilla with a short touch. Now working it forward. Near tackle. This one kicked and right at the keeper, Howard.
Yeah, Howard didn't have to move for that one either.
Couple saves thus far for Howard.
Enright.
Enright going to pass it to the middle. A little movement here. Nice move. Degner going to go forward. Great tackle. What a way to win that ball there. Now this one sent directly up the middle. Dangerous spot coming up for it. Gregson gets hit and goes down. He won the ball and then got caught on the
He's
ankles here.
Card.
Yeah,
He's
you have to do
card.
That. Momentum was going forward.
Now, that's Sam Hall. I mean, we didn't see him at all yesterday, did we?
He was in the game, but he didn't start.
Okay.
Today, he got a start here, and he got caught with a yellow card because the keeper, Austin Gregson, had control of the ball, and he kept going and just caught him on the ankles.
Well, number 18, Travis Ostrowski, comes in for Sam Hall at this point. And Travis was a big part of their game yesterday.
Going to have a free kick here, and this goes out. And now another call here. Looked like Hall was going to come back in, and now Coach Alan High had brought him back over to the bench to talk for a few minutes. Free kick sent in, top of the box, headed out. Nice job. Herscher's defense being a bit stingy here. Now on the run here on the counter. This one sent to the middle. A little bit too far. Good job here. Shields sending that one out, headed back. Head ball towards the middle. Strowski going to send this one short, a little bit too far. Tried to reach up with Colin Lund, but that one sent out towards the wide side. This ball kicked out will be a throw-in for the Tigers. Good throw down the line, headed out though. Tigers taking control. Herscher trying to make something happen. Nice touch move to outside. Good job to recover. Gets the ball back. Put up a shot. This one high and above the bar. Minutes in this first half of the Class 1A State Championship. Ron Pecorini, Rusty Silber with you on the IHSA TV network. If you're just joining with us, this is a state championship in 1A. Herscher from just around the Kankakee area, Waterloo, Gibault, southeast of St. Louis area, in the southwest part of the state. So two teams at two different areas of the state don't get an opportunity to play against one another.
Right, right, definitely. Well, here they are. They might not play during the regular season, but they are playing for the championship.
Battle here, and this is going to go out. They're going to call this a corner kick. Well played over there by Mitch Meyer. Mantilla going to take the corner. We're going to call him the specialist.
No, he's definitely special. I could tell you that. This kid's got a
up in the air, and this one going a little bit too long. The wind might have carried that out a little bit.
I don't think he realizes.
Top of the box. Meyer tried to take a kick here, and this one deflected out.
And I think he realized the difference of his little chip putting the ball up in that area, in that little gully there.
Trenton Cruz is the one that sent that ball out for the Tigers.
And going out right now is number 5, Jack Lamy. And coming in, number 17,
this one sent
Zach
in.
Reuter.
Howard comes up with that catch and sends it out quickly. Nice idea to outlet that out. He's done that a couple times now. This one will go out the far side in front of the bench. Throw in. And this one's going to roll out on the far side here. It'll be a throw-in going back to the Tigers. We got a substitution here for Herscher.
Coming in, number 4, Ethan Shield. I'm sorry. Number 4 is going to be Colin Lung. And number 9, Dustin Love for the Hawks.
And now Hawks trying to push forward. Pass here in the middle. On the run. We got a bit of a collision there. And free kick coming up here. Schwarzkopf tried to make a run there and got hit
Nick
on the
Rowe.
Side. And good player, and he's going to find his way to draw the foul. So now we got a free kick towards the center, about 35 yards out. Schwarzkopf, one of the captains, is going to take this. Looking around, everybody standing on the 18. Line drive kick, and it was saved. Now it's loose, and it's a goal. On the rebound, the Tigers take advantage.
That was number 12, Colton Walter.
Austin Gregson did a great job. We're going to get a look at this. Just to keep that ball in front of him, but he couldn't seal it in. And then right in a one-time kick on the loose ball.
Nice,
and one thing you look at this is the fact that for some reason they're like Tigers around the prowl. And Herscher has this way of getting themselves the opportunity, sees the opportunity to get the goal.
Yeah, this discussion out there. Captain Nick Rowe has got the referee's ears on this one. I think it's still regards to that play, how it got set up.
Well, Nick Rowe saying something with the
back of his leg, and he was the one that was charged for the free kick that set this whole goal up. Didn't expect that. Didn't see that coming right now. I tell you, I thought Gibault would be out by now.
So Herscher scores the opening goal in the 22nd minute. And Herscher with the 1-0, as we said, we think it's going to be a defensive game, but opportunities present themselves. And Herscher has found their way to get opportunities in the state tournament when you least expect it. Here's a cross here, stepping in, and almost an opportunity on a one-time near post kick
Schwarzkopf
there.
Schwarzkopf came in out of nowhere, flying high with a nice kick. Look at this one.
Gregson came off his line, too, and that opened the door for the opportunity for Schwarzkopf. I don't know if he would have shot that if he stayed on the line.
No, he was going. He was already up in the air. That decision was made. Deflect wasn't the right way, but it was good. It's a nice play.
Herscher's got a little more energy right now. They send it back down again. Head ball coming near side, double team. And this will go out and should belong to the Hawks. It was right off the leg of Colton Walter.
And that was Colton Walter, who is a junior. And that was his second goal of the season.
And you wonder if this goal, obviously a lot bigger than the other one he had this season.
Oh, well. Right now, this is the biggest goal in his career, or the season at least.
This one going through. Schwarzkopf, look at the speed, a battle for it here. And both players go down, and they're going to call the foul here. And good sportsmanship to bring up. Both of them working hard for it. Schwarzkopf called for the foul as both Nick Rowe and Schwarzkopf went down here.
Yeah, it was a good play. I mean, they were both going for it. They were both toughing it out. It was really no one's fault at this point. It just got tangled up and they went down.
You got some hard-nosed type players here. They're going to work out here for what they want to get. This ball taking a bounce, set down. And not much of an opportunity for the Hawks to do anything. This kick to the side. Throw in. Enright. Looking around, looking. Now he's going to send it. Now he's going to get a bit of a run on this. Near side of the box, head ball towards the middle. Defense going to get it, and this one kicked in the air, still out of trouble. Now it's completely out of the area. And a battle for it again. This one sent down, Shields down the wing. And this is going to roll almost out. Nope, it stays in. Tigers trying to get something to roll here, Walter. And he let that ball go out. Enright, send it in. Turn in here, touch, back to Enright. Enright gonna try to serve one here, and that's gonna go up and over the bar. That's got the wind behind him too.
Yeah, not only that, I think Enright's been frustrated. He's been hitting, nothing seems to be going his way. He's kind of frustrated. I think that was just one shot out of frustration. No reason to take that shot. He had guys on the back end.
25 minutes into this first half of this Class 1A state final. Ron Pecorini, Rusty Silver here with you. Hope your evening's a good one here tonight. Right now, Herscher with a 1-0 advantage. And Colin Walter with the goal in a 22nd minute.
Oh, he got pulled
down. And we got a foul here. And this will be a free kick coming up.
Looks like Enright went down. He's been in a lot of little shuffles so far.
And Mantilla setting this up. Of course, he's going to take it. Long kick here. And it's going to be caught with the breeze going right to left a little bit. Mantilla with the kick in the box. Head ball and in.
It's in.
Flicked it in.
Wow. Wes Deniger comes through. And that's his third goal of the two games so far. And that was Frank, as she is, number 24 assists. What a chip. Look at this one again, folks.
Well placed.
Right in there.
Head flick and
beautiful
in.
Beautiful header. Ah, sweet, as they say.
Something was telling me that Mantilla was going to step up on a set piece and create something, and there you go.
I said, both teams, this is going to be a good one, Rusty. This has got everything lined up for it.
You said earlier there may not be much scoring. I got a feeling we're going to see some good quality goals here
on both
sides. Well,
those are two good goals. No, they were very good goals here so far. I just don't see it's going to be a blowout like we just witnessed. I just think it's going to be an exciting, good game. And it is so far.
1-1 at the moment. And we're waiting referees to let the play begin after the goal. Wes Stegener picking up the goal. Mantilla with the assist. All tied up at one. A lot of fans out here from both sides. I think Herscher might have the advantage over the, I hate to say this, over a lot of the Waterloo Gibault fans. This one's sent in the box, and it's going to be caught just in front of the goal line by the keeper, Gregson. Now ball taken down midfield, sent down the line. This will go out, though. Good idea. I like the idea by Enright trying to work the sideline, try to send it down to the corner.
Nice little kick.
This ball deflected, touch, kept alive. Schwarzkopf, or make that's not, that's...
Sam Pekunis.
That's, yeah, Pekunis able to send this one down to the... The Tigers able to get it to the top of the box, now kicked away. Throw in here for the Tigers. Brody Ryan will take the throw. Light's taking some more effect here. And this is a time of day that when you go day to night, you get a lot of people saying that sometimes you can't see the ball certain ways. Yeah, I know in other sports it's said that way. But to be honest, in soccer, it happens a little bit too. You see the ball differently as it goes day to night.
Yeah, it's not going to last long. We'll take them a little bit into halftime, and then it will be all over. Then we'll definitely be under the lights.
Right now, we're evened at one here. Tigers trying to get something to work in their favor to get the ball forward. Enright, though, intercept. Pass right on the right side of the box. A near chance for Degener. He's going to have to take it to the line and try to bring it back out.
But that
good
was
defense.
A beautiful seed pass.
Mantilla looking for a move, trying to get out space, gets a short touch. Couldn't create anything there. And that time, I got to say, there was some good defense by the Tigers. This kick is going to go over the top. I want to give credit to Mantilla, move along the right side of the box, because Brody Ryan did a good job to stay with them. Didn't let him get any much space there.
No, looking good.
Howard with a long punt on the goal kick. This one brought down, in control. Pass to the back now. And this will roll out, be a throw in here. Hawks looking to make this one quick. Oh, now finally going to throw it in. This one kicked back. And a little bit of ball possession, bring it back defensively. I don't think we've seen that much here today. Possession, just a matter of moving the ball forward. This one cut off, Shields. Pass to the middle. Nice move to almost beat a player. Now pass to the wing. Mantilla going to get control here. Ryan got cut a little bit into it. Mantilla going to send one far side of the box and near opportunity on the header on the move here.
Beautiful left foot with that one also. Put it right where it should have been. Couple of those boys let him down. Perfect height for the for
Jack
some headers.
Lammy was the one on that far side and almost got himself a header or a foot on it. That's not what we've seen out of Mantilla on the run trying to set up a play. We've seen it more on the set pieces.
But he's got perfect. He knows exactly where he wants to put that ball. He sees the field really well.
This one-time kick far side, and Gregson's able to pick that up. You know, it's amazing because you find players like Mantilla that there's only a dime a dozen when you see these players because they have field vision that is just, I hate to use the word uncanny. I mean, it's not something you see every day. And I can think in my mind over the years of following soccer that there may be a dozen players that I've seen that just have this great field vision, unbelievable vision that they can place the ball where they want it and they put it there.
It's definitely one of the best I've seen at a high school level.
Howard will pick up this ball. But it's just amazing when you think about that because players believe they can do that. But to see it actually done time after time in the certain spaces of the field and how you get the ball to be directed right on the, like a dime, I mean, right on the player's head, it's amazing.
I truly believe he really works hard at his skill. It's just that good.
And really, when you think about it, somebody at this level, as a high school senior, is really playing at a different level of soccer when you're doing that. I mean, you're taking yourself to a college level, or even the thoughts in your mind, maybe at a professional level, doing what he's doing right now.
Well, no question about it. He's definitely ahead of the regular high school player. He's got it. You can just see. He's just a natural, Rusty. He really is.
Mm-hmm. Right now we're in the 31st minute of play, tied 1-1. Long throw in here. And head ball takes a bounce and finally cleared away. And head ball to the side. Hawks trying to make something work here. Degner stops, tries to cut it back, had it kicked off his feet. This will go out. There'll be a corner kick. Give credit to the defense once again for the Tigers. Zach Simmons, a senior, able to kick that ball away.
We all know who's going to take the PK now.
Mantilla lining up his corner. Going to go right foot. Mantilla on the short side coming in. Howard got a hand on it, now kicked away. And look out on the run. Is that Schwarzkopf? It is. 1-on-1. And Dean Chase, a little help, trying to get squeezed, gets knocked down from behind. Play goes on, the ball goes out. From behind, after he had made contact, Jack Lamy caught him.
Beautiful breakaway.
No foul called or anything, it's just going to be a throw.
Speed.
Long throw in, Colin Lund, bouncing in the box, header up in the air. Battle in the box, and this one up. Still not out completely. Herscher keeping it alive, takes a funny bounce. Now a head ball sent forward. Jack Reuter. And this one touched, finally cleared away. Well, it's kept in and kept alive. Touch back to the middle. Waterloo, Gibault taking possession now. They're able to take it forward. And they really got a break there because that could have been a possible chance for a goal. Right into space. Outside of the box. Good defense. Simmons doing a good job to take it. Trying to make a move. This one cleared away and will go to Herscher. Little claim there that it went off the Herscher player.
Now we got just under 7 minutes to go here, folks.
Yeah,
and
so
you're watching
back
a doozy of a game.
Herscher will throw this in. Another good throw. A little bit too far. Touch here. Reuter going to be sent back. And a missed head ball there by Shields. Top of the box. That's danger. And again kicked by Shields. Into the middle. Gets a little help this time. Now a pass to Mantilla. He's got room on the outside. Mantilla looking. Cuts to the left. Now he's got space. Gets hit from the side. And he got a foul called here.
Yeah,
that foul is going to be on Sam Hall.
Sam's a little aggressive right now.
I'll tell you, Sam's got to be careful, though, because he got a yellow card earlier. And Tia might be a little bit shaken up with a hit from the side. Waiting to get the ball back. A free kick. Approaching the 36-minute mark. And Teo set this one up about 30 yards out. What does he have in his game plan here? Little chip, top of the box. Howard coming in, gets a hand on it.
Oof.
And got it on the bounce. Boy, he read that well.
Wow, that was sweet. That was a nice kick. Fortunately, just could not get it. About 2 inches, maybe just missed his player's head.
I'll tell you, Mantilla, that was almost like a chip.
Yeah, number 12, Wes was there ready to do another one, if you ask me.
You know, it's amazing about the way he kicks that ball. It's like a chip, but it hangs in the air. And the wind is behind that ball.
He's just got it. He's just got it.
Throwing now for the Tigers here. A little bit too long. It'll come back out. Short touch by Degener. That one didn't work by Meyer. Now it comes back the other way. Hall going to send it off to the right side. This one sent to the far side of the field. Touch. Tigers trying to create something here. And this one set to the wing side. Working the end line. This one crossed in. Backdoor chance header. Nope, doesn't go. And cleared away. Degener. Missed kick here. And Tigers are going to work their way back in. Simmons. Now Hall. Had it for a moment. Can deflect it. Work for position here. Going to kept alive. Working to the end line. Slide tackle and going down there. Stewart had a touch. This will be a throw-in. Tigers will take it here. Opportunity knocking. Final few minutes of this first half. Well, they're going to call this a corner. Actually, I thought it was a throw initially. But I'll give credit because Zach Simmons was trying to make it a corner. Now Simmons is going to drop the ball down. We'll get a change here on the thrower.
Colin Lund coming in for it.
Lund, one of the forwards, a little running start. Throws it in the air, near side, and coming forward is Gregson, and we're going to have a goal kick here as this ball was headed out.
Almost just about 3 minutes to go here, Rusty. We're watching a real good, exciting game, folks.
Tied up at one apiece. Goal kick sent out. Head ball forward. Tiger was able to get ahead on it back the other way. A little bit of a touch. That one won there, Mantilla. A little short drop, and that one, good job. Able to read it and block it from going anywhere. Nice move there. And another good move. Able to work the wing. And working up Hall now. Trying to cut it inside. A little too much. This one kicked away. This one sent back. Battle for Hall with an extra effort. And he got himself hobbling a little bit there. He works hard.
Yes, he does. He's aggressive. I'm just concerned that he's going to be one aggressive too many.
Marcunas had a throw in. This one sent back. Now back forward. Degener had it. Tigers able to try to get control. Degener battling for this. He's got position on the line. Good pass. Gets up off to Mantilla. Mantilla with a little space, throwing it underneath. And couldn't catch up to his forward. And this one cleared away. Hall going to send it to the far side. Good cut across. Near opportunity, but not able to get to it. It's going to go out. Actually, it's going to stay in. That one was saved there. And good takeaway. Play goes on. Got some good 50-50 balls on the tackles to be taken away here. Now a long kick downfield. Trying to take control. This one kicked away a bit. Good job to come back for this one. Working the line, going to drop it off. Nope, going to take it forward. Mantilla going to throw it off the right side of his foot here. And a little too far.
A little break in the action. Just under 1 minute to go here. Going into halftime, 1-1. And this is a doozy of a game.
Line drive kick. It's going to be kept alive here by the Hawks. Going to try to set something up. Short drop off Mantilla. Off to the left side. Good patience now here for the Hawks. Going to send it to the near side. On the run. Enright and Chase. Had it knocked off the ball there. Now here comes Hall on the run. Going to send it downfield. And got it past his forward. And this ball is going to run out. Good job there. I got to give credit to the defense just to watch that ball with the speed. Andrew Reinholtz able to follow the ball out as we get down to the final 10 seconds of the first half.
They're probably just going to let it sit and it's okay. Going to go into halftime. Why even get a chance?
That's going to do it. 40 minutes done in this championship game in Class 1A. We're tied 1-1. And take a look at the goals, both of them. This one right off the hands of Gregson, able to foul it up and put that in. A big goal there by Walter. And then back the other way. You got to like when this one's set up by Mantilla. Flick in. Degner with the goal. So we're tied at one. We'll take a break. Stay with us. More high school Class 1A soccer right on the IHSA TV network. Welcome back to the Corn Crib in Normal, Illinois. Ron Pecorini, Rusty Silver, the Class 1A state championship. Getting ready for the second half. And Ron, 1-1 tie. What do these teams have to do here in the second half?
Oh, wow. Just one of them needs to score one more than the other. How does that sound?
But the way things are going between both teams, you know, opportunities seem to be there on both sides. But you kind of have this feeling that with Mantilla out there, any free kicks, you're going to have the advantage is going to be favoring Waterloo Gibault, the way his talent level can produce these goals.
And, yes, I agree with you 100% on this one. I definitely think the key right now is Frank Mantilla. That's going to be the key in this game. I think that's what they need to control him. They got to isolate him and keep him out of the picture, and they're going to have to basically work that much harder for them to attack. So the Tigers do have, I think, a little more work than our Hawks do.
I was going to say, the Tigers, though, have to create more chances. Of course, I can see the goalkeeper right here waiting on the goal line in case they pull off what they did last night. Remember what they did last night?
Yeah,
they kicked a long shot. I can see right away Gregson's on the goal line looking.
Well, they didn't do it, but they certainly looked like they were going to.
The way they set up, they look like. And this one kicked will be a goal kick. Or is it going to be a corner? It will be a corner kick here. So in the first few seconds here, we've seen what the Hawks can do last night in a semifinal. Now they get an opportunity here in the second half to try to do something here off a corner kick.
No. It's only going to take one for either one of these guys.
Pekunis will take the corner. This one up in the air. Gregson able to get up there, punch it away. And this one cleared away. Back to the Tigers side of the field. The ball's going to roll all the way back. Howard's just going to let it roll and then pick it up. And Howard's just going to get a good punt into this. Headed back out by the Hawks. Challenge up in the air. Takes a big bounce. Now off the left side of the box. Cleared away by the Hawks. This one will be sent out towards the bench. This will be a throw-in here. Just underway in the second half. And Herscher has to seize any opportunity that they can get. They don't seem like a team that can develop goals that we've seen the last 2 days. But when they get a little momentum and something rides on their side, then it's a different story.
Yeah, they definitely know how to set up play type game. They're just working and trying to make any mistake from the other team.
I will say, on the other hand, last night, Waterloo Gibault set up opportunities. They created. They made things start to develop momentum in their favor. And you wonder if that's happening again. They were down 1-0. They got the one goal. And you got this feeling there might be more setups here to happen.
Well, yes, this is why, you know.
This one's set underneath, and quickly Gregson comes out and slides for the ball.
That's why my prediction in the beginning was that I thought Gibault might have the upper hand because of what we saw, how they set up. They were in better position to make things happen.
Battle for the ball here outside of the box. One there by the Hawks for a moment, then cleared away. This one taking a bounce and sent forward on a one-time kick on the side of the box here. Ball's going to roll. We got a little bit of a battle of a handheld. And yeah, we're going to have a foul here, or is this going to be
Colin Lund just grabbed all over the defender on that one, started twisting his body around. Very good call by the AR.
Well, Free kick from the corner. Sent to the middle. And taken down, pass over to the far side. And this will be chase and roll, and this is going to be kept in. Good job there. A bit of a deflection here. And this will go out. It'll be belonging to the Hawks. Shields will take the throw down the line. Head ball, and this stayed in. And this one sent forward. Hawks trying to create something here. Drop back pass. And working it around a little bit. I like the way they did this here. Francesen now drops it off. Enright. Enright trying to make a move. Cut to the inside a bit. Has some space. Fires a shot. A little off the arc there to the left side.
No, that's what they had to do. If you ask what they got to do, you got to take some shots.
Like
there
the,
you go.
Like the play, how he took the space and tried to turn it a little bit. Didn't get a full kick out of it.
No, but I think Howard would have been there anyway. He had that post command.
Degner drop it off. Mantilla out to the wing side. This one kicked out. Right off of Jude Stewart. Thrown in far side, trying to get position. And this one's going to be kicked out again. Another throw in here for the Hawks. Tied at one. Right at the corn crib, Class 1A. State finals. Into the corner here, off the throw-in. Trying to make a move, trying to get around. It's going to be a corner kick. Just a reminder, we should say the Class 2A and 3A state finals next week will be at Hoffman Estates High School, not in Frankfurt this year. So if you're headed out there for the state Class 2A and 3A, then make sure you get yourself at the right spot at Hoffman Estates High School next weekend, Friday and Saturday, 11-1, 5-7 both days. Corner kick sent in. Howard comes down with it. Well, and a quick outlet height. Out.
Definitely use his height to that advantage. He needs to be up there like.
Ball sent forward here. One time kick sent back out. Off the touch. Galaz had it. Now sent to the middle. Working the right side. Going to fire a shot. And Gregson watched that one go by. Schwarzkopf tying his shoes right now. Here's a guy that you can't leave open, whether he's going to fire the ball, if he's going to run. He's the main man that you expect to go towards the goal.
Yeah, you can't give a player like that any room. I mean, that's one that you need to just be on his feet. Give him no room, period.
Head ball flick. This one going to be sent back a little bit. And chase. Kicked it aside. This will bounce out. This will be a throw-in for the Hawks. Or make a throw-in coming up here for Enright. Brought down. Little move trying to turn. And trying to get through. That's not going to work. Ball goes out. He got confused with the wrong line.
He got the wrong line.
Unfortunately, Meyer thought it was out, but that was the baseline. This isn't the line that we're using out here.
Very easy to get confused.
Well, I was going to say it's the same color, too, with white. This fired shot on far post, and that just skipped by. Howard let that go by, and Degner almost found some iron on that far side.
Yeah, take a look at his shot, folks. It was not
right off the throw here. Watch this. He didn't even hesitate. Boom. And that wasn't by much.
No.
I will say this. Howard might have been in the wrong position for that shot.
He was, and Zach Rutner just was too far back. He didn't hit the post.
This one sent, and we'll keep rolling it out. If you take a notice of this field, you see it looks like a baseball field because it is in the summertime, but in the fall, it's used as a soccer field. Not only for the high schools here, but I guess the area colleges within the Bloomington-Normal area use this field here.
And that is brown turf, not brown sand.
That's all turf on the field. And pretty good turf. Referee got caught in a spot there. Now the Hawks trying to make a move into the box area, and we got a collision and a fall. We got a PK. Yep.
That's it. It's there.
Mantilla made the move into the box, and got tripped up, and it's going to be a PK.
Yep, absolutely. He's getting up slowly, though. He is getting up slowly.
Get a look on the move by Mantilla, the quickness. Try to take an opportunity. And he gets into the box. A little bit of contact there, and he got the call. So a PK coming up.
And what's it going to look like? It looks like Mitch Meyer, team leading scorer. Or...
well, let's see. They're changing things up here. Looked like it was Meyer. Now Reinholtz is stepping up to take it, which surprises me that Mantilla isn't taking himself.
I think he's hurt. I think he's bothered by it.
But then again, we're not 100% sure who the best penalty kick shooters are on this team. So Reinholtz, who had a head ball goal in the semifinal, will now go after the PK. Referee talking to the goalkeeper what you can do and what you can't do.
Well, Reinholtz has 12 goals this season.
Now we're set. Wait for the whistle here. Reinholtz with the kick and right in the corner. Howard couldn't do anything.
Howard
2-0.
2-1. 2-1.
2-1 now.
Yep. That was nice. Here it is. Look at that play. Howard takes one step. He was on his heels. If we can see that again. Watch his, as a goalie, you cannot be on your heels. And I'm going to look at that because I want to see if I can catch that again. The goalie's in his way, but yeah, he came down. He came down on his heels. And goalie, you cannot. You have to be on your toes so that you can shift your body either way, and that's why he got caught completely frozen. And well, Howard, he's a junior. Oh, he should already have known that already. But and again, it is 2-1, 32 minutes to go, and this is still an exciting championship round here for the 1A championship.
48th minute, Andrew Reinholtz with the goal. And a 2-1 lead now for the Waterloo Gibault Hawks. Herscher looking to work their way back. Pass here left side. That one stopped. Battle for on the far side. This one will be sent to the top of the box. Head ball. Not cleared out though. And finally it is cleared. And quickly upfield. Good job, take control, end right. Short pass here, not the best spot, but able to clear it forward, one of the other defenders. Battle to the other side, Shields and Chase.
And Sam
and Sam Hall battling. This will go to the Herscher. Herscher has a huge crowd following out here, sitting down in front of us. I would say about 60% of the crowd is from Herscher here. And most of them are standing right now, too. We're going to call for a free kick here. And the referee has stopped the clock. He's going to walk over and talk to the assistant referee. We have an injury here. Ostrowski's coming in. Free kick, short pass down the wing here. Wheeler going after it. This one sent to the top. A turn move, that one kicked away. Still kept alive, down the wing to the left side. And this one's going to be kicked out.
Got a corner kick out of that one. Good drive, good push.
It was a pretty good push on that one with Sam Pakunas, who will go over and take the corner. Kuhn is going to send this in. Backside trouble and still kept in. It's going to roll out now. And was it touched? And I think it was. It'll be another corner.
Oh, okay.
Looks like there was a deflection in there. Ostrowski is going to come over and take this corner. He's got a lot of assists for this team. 20 of them coming in. Short man coming in from the back, from defense, stepping up. Makes a move. This one kicked away momentarily, still kept alive. Now sent downfield. Nobody out there, but for either team. Stepped up as Howard's going to send it up close to the 18. A little bit of a breeze behind him there. Now this one going to be kicked away. Good job on defense there for Nick Rowe. Now on the run.
Wes.
On the far side, opportunity. Going to be kept in. Pass to the top. And good job defensively. Got to give credit for the defense. Nick Wheeler stepped in and fired that ball out. Hawks keeping this one alive, but Tigers are battling. We got a foul here. This will be a free kick. Bit on the heels there of Jaeger Erickson. Well, the 51st minute here, 2-1 in favor of Waterloo Gibault. This one sent it to the top. A lot of the Tigers holding back here now. Line drive kick here, well over the bar. That one sent pretty far there by Colin Lund. And you would think at this point that the Tigers, yeah, they're pressing for the goal, but they need to get some better touches and get somewhere within the penalty area to get a better shot.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. They are just taking shots from 20, 25, 30 yards. Ain't going to happen. They need to make a move to the inside.
And then foul I don't see any numbers. Now we got a foul here. It seems like more of the Tigers are staying midfield opposed to getting closer to the box area. It's going to be kind of hard to create something if you don't have anybody to pass to.
No, they're down by one. We still got just under 28 minutes. They still have some time to at least get a tie. You can't do too many mistakes against the Hawks because they will take advantage of you.
This one in the middle of the field, kept alive. Good touch on the backside there by Enright. Now working the far side. Good patience there by the Hawks, able to take control of the ball. And that's the one kicked away. I mean, you see a lot of Tigers are holding back, playing more defensive here.
Yeah, we got a penalty, a little foul there.
Here's what, 7-8 players staying back for the Hawks right now.
Well, we got a free kick for Frank Mathia.
For Mantilla?
Mantilla.
And he's going to take this about close to 30 yards. Three-man wall. Keep an eye on Reinholtz, Degener. Mantilla going to send it in.
Wes again.
Wes had the opportunity. Howard late getting to where the ball was. And Degener put it over the bar.
There you go. Wes is at 6'3". He's one of three players on that team that are 6'3".
Yeah,
and
look at it there.
He gets over it.
He beat Howard of the ball.
And Howard is 6'3", so nice height fight that is.
It's almost like a looping, lofting kick that comes in by Mantilla. It's not one that a lot of times you see someone kick the free kicks that kind of hang up in the air.
Yeah, no, he's got that down to a T. I'm telling you, Rusty, it's great watching him take these shots.
So dangerous on these set pieces. And they're going to call a push here.
They're going to call Mitch Meyer on that one.
Mitch Meyer looked like he got pushed into the play here.
Yeah, and yet he got the call.
Free kick coming up here for Herscher. Nice booming kick in the box. Headed out. Kept alive here. Touch. Trying to get the touch back to the inside, coming off the line. Good play, a little bit of collision there. Now ball sent forward. Degener had it for a moment. And now it's touched back on the one of the defenders. I can see Herscher pushing up some of the defense now, trying to get numbers forward. Some batter for Hall. Brought down, passed towards the box, headed out. Hawks are doing a good job. Now I got a collision, couple guys down, and play continues to go on. Touch here, good head ball to clear, and fired away to the other side of the field. Referee's letting the contact go right now.
Yeah, that was a little dangerous play back there, though. But he let it go. He went advantage.
Simmons will throw this in the far side from the bench. Long throw across the midfield, headed back out. Another throw coming. 16 minutes into play. Actually, this ball's going to be placed over to the Hawks here. Going to be a free kick. A foul called right about midfield. Shields. This one kicked back the other way. Good touch. And a slide tackle to clear the ball away for a moment. Tigers, another good slide tackle twice in this sequence. Got to give credit there for defense on Nick Rowe. The Tigers trying to go forward. Nick Rowe says no twice. Tigers trying to work the outside now. In the corner, this one sent across, coming forward. Great job by Gregson, able to slide and take the ball. He's doing a good job corralling the ball after what happened in the first half.
No, like I said, we got two very good keepers here representing their teams.
Gregson with four saves on the night. Head ball and cleared away. And still being kept in. Hawks trying to go forward, trying to get another goal if they can with a one-goal advantage. Head ball going forward. Lamy had the touch here. And this is going to be knocked out. And let's stay with the... What's going to be called there? It's going to be... It looked like it was going to go the other way.
Yeah, they called that one against Erickson. I just think the ref was definitely blindsided on that one.
Well, the AR here might have been the one that made the call on it, too. Substitution here. Enright's going to take the throw. Now we're ready. Enright going to throw this in. And this ball was just let go, and it's going to roll out. I think Enright got a little lost here, thinking the baseball line there was the actual line to throw the ball in, because he kind of hesitated before he threw it in.
That line's been a problem the whole weekend.
Now we said, why don't you just line up the field with the baseline? Good idea. However, home plate would come in order, and I don't think you can get home plate taken off the field.
Well, no.
We discussed that in the semifinals. This ball goes out. It'll be a throw in here for Waterloo Gibault. Hawks trying to work the line. And Tia sets the ball down, now passes back out. Now the cross here, just gonna be kicked away. Erickson doing a good job on defense. This one fired in off the mark. That one sent on towards the goal. Franceskin. And now with some changes being made. Matt Reeb making some switches. Substitutions to come in as we hit just about the halfway point of this Class 1A state final.
Trying to get some fresh legs in there right now. Just trying to rest some of his starters in case he needs to get them back in there.
This one sent to the far side. Good job to get up in the air and knock that one down. A lot of credit on that one to Sam Pakunas. This one sent towards the middle. Head ball back. And here come the Tigers on the run, and this one sent off the mark here. One thing I'm looking around, I don't see Schwarzkopf. Oh, there he is up front. But he hasn't really been much of a factor here in the second half.
No, not yet. Not yet. A couple of breakaways on the first half, but right now he's been quiet. They're kind of shutting him down.
This one sent forward. Now Schwarzkopf is going to touch the ball here. A little chip to the left side, but he's got nobody there. This one cleared away. Go to the far side. Now this one sent and blocked out. An attempted shot there by Nick Wheeler. Now they work the middle, a touch, a back touch there, and that would have been a good idea if it worked. Hall tried to hook up with Schwarzkopf, and that was just a little bit off target there. Nice takeaway there by Zach Simmons. See a little more defensive plays going on here. And a battle here, and good help coming from the backside there by Colin Lund. And now a foul called, and we got a little bit of extra. Stuff that was taken care of. Free kick coming up here for the Tigers. Nick Wheeler will send this to the middle, off to the left, headed back. Now kick towards the middle. Trap here, sent forward. This will bounce to Howard. He'll get it off in the hop. High kick here. I was going to say, most kicks we've had today have been low.
Yep. Well, he's getting a little bit of that wind.
Yeah. I'd say wind has died down a bit. Now look at the flagpole here. Degener going to make a move. Now patience. He'll send it back. Gets a little help. Zach Reuter in the game. And one pass back. Degener, now they're going to work back. Franceschi, nice touch move. Good move to beat the man. Now he passes, drops it off. This one off the target a little bit, a bump there. Play continues to go on. Franceschi going to put this one up in the air, off to the far side. Short hop there. Zach Reuter going to take a touch there, mishandled. Fights for it, gets it back. Reuter going to make the move here, going to look towards the end line. And battling for it, ball's going to roll out, and this will be a goal kick. Sam Pakunis doing a good job back there, helping out for the Tigers. Howard with the honors of the goal kick. 2-1 our score here. Waterloo Gibault with the lead, and Herscher trying to find the equalizer. Ball sent to the middle. Mantilla had it, lost it. Now it's going to be kicked away. See, Mantilla's gone back a little more defensive after the goal.
Right now, well, they can keep him back there. They do have the lead.
And we got a little bit of a collision on the far side.
All right.
And a foul free kick coming up.
We get the ball to the Tigers here.
Wheeler with the free kick, headed back.
Well, he gets all over the place, though, Frank. He sees this ball and field really well. He's a pleasure to watch.
Big battle, and one of the players falling forward. Play goes on, and this is going to roll out. This should be a goal kick at this point.
Well, you got about 16 minutes to go here, Rusty, and we are watching a very, very good game.
Clock has been stopped. Referee's walking over to talk to the assistant referee on the far side of the field, right in front of the bench here. Not exactly sure why.
Gotta give a card to somebody.
Yep.
All right. AR got a card.
I think it was on the bench, the coach, it looks like.
Yeah, it must have been the coach.
Alan High from Herscher.
I didn't see anything like that, but obviously the AR did not appreciate what was going on the sideline.
Goal kick coming up here for the Hawks. And it's going to be brought down. Tigers going to take the ball away. Opportunity here. Pass underneath, and good job to clear the ball away to read that. Give a lot of credit towards Ethan Shields working hard on that right side of the defense. You can talk about supporting one another back there defensively, and that was a play where you needed that support.
Yeah, that's chemistry and talking and communications all about.
Long high throw, this one headed out here. Ball one time sent to the far side. Strowski going to send this not across, but went behind the net and out. Another goal kick coming up.
Well, we're approaching 15 minutes here. Time is now looking to be on the Hawks' side. Tigers got to make something happen soon.
Reinholtz with the goal kick and headed back. Nice job to send forward. That one misplayed. Tigers going to take control on the back line. A little bit of possession here. Work it from left to right. This one sent forward. Not a good kick there. And here come the Hawks. Degner going to cross one towards the middle. Has some help. Into the middle. Another extra touch. Don't work. Degner going to kick it into the middle. Finds a man. One time touch. He had the opportunity to put it in the back of the net, but Ryder couldn't get the full foot on it.
Yeah, look at that. Stepped in and just
It took a funny but good bounce off his right foot, but he couldn't get the left foot squared enough with the laces on the goal. There was a favorable bounce, though. And here come the Hawks again. Move on the outside, shook his man off, going to keep it alive in the corner, stops, going to try to reverse it. Now sends it back out with a little bit of help. Mattia sends it back to the wing. Working that same line again, gets around the defender. Looking for some help, lost the ball for a second, still alive. And the Tigers getting control back there. Good move to get around the problem and then send it out. Tigers trying to make forward movement here on the run. Making the pass. Coming up is Gregson. He's going to pick it up. And he's making sure he's got every ball.
Mm-hmm. He better. That's his job.
Well, with the goal that Herscher got in the first half, it's understandable.
So you have to like the way Wes's Degner is playing. I tell you, he has to make
this
a
might
lot
be a
of
corner. Oh, he kept it in, yes. I don't think so. Nope, the AR pointed it was out. He kicked it back, and it caught the corner flag. But the referee said right away, this is interesting, too.
What, I think they got to make it a throw-in.
You see this, if he saved it, it went over, let's see. No, it looked like he did save it, so it will be a throw.
Yep.
Pretty hard for the AR to get a full view of it. The referee was right in front here. But it was a good save, and it hit the corner flag and stayed on the side for the throw-in. And right, long throw, top of the six, head ball. Mm. Nobody there in the backside. Howard's going after it. Dive. Ball comes out. Oh, no, he did get it.
He did get it, but it looked like he actually got the ankles to number 17, Zach Reuter.
Nice long kicker by Howard. Ball placed down. Mantilla making the move, looking. Long kick, trying to go direct to the top. Reinholtz had it. Can't take control of it.
Tell you, I'm surprised. We just haven't seen Mitch Meyer do anything as a goal leader.
Actually, that was Mitch Meyer, not Reinholtz. Reinholtz is more on defense. Meyer was the one that brought the ball down, but couldn't really do anything there. Degener had the ball kicked away from him. Nick Wheeler, good job on defense. Again, the Hawks trying to set it up. Missed pass there, but controlled once again. We'll work the ball back here a little bit from the back. Not a good move. Nice little fake move there. Good touch. Francesca now lost there, taken away. But it's taken away back the other way. Good play in the midfield both ways.
Nice move.
Now
there,
on the run.
Stewart.
And we got a collision here. taking the ball forward. Play goes on. Jute Stewart got taken down. No call. Herscher still with the ball here, trying to work the middle. Touch here, going to the top. Chipped up in the air. This is trouble coming in. It's Gregson up in the air. Head ball up and goes wide. Oh, we almost had the equalizer that Herscher was looking for. Gregson went up. And Brody Ryan got the head on this, but couldn't put it on the frame. It took a bounce and went wide of the post. Oh. You wonder if there was a contact or not with the ball from Gregson, because if there was, there might have been some sort of spin on it which caused it to go to the side.
Don't know on that one. Hard to tell on the replay. We're too far up here to see exactly what's going on.
There was a chance there for Herscher to tie it up. A battle here in the back. This goes out. Tigers will get the ball back again. Six saves now for Gregson, four in the second half. Pass under, Enright. Enright going to get the touch here on the near side, working with the ball, trying to take some time off the clock. Double team gets away from it. Pass under, good job. Slide tackle, and it's going to be kicked away by the Tigers. Not completely, oh. And now we got a back touch, and play will go on. Nothing called. Degner's on the ground, though. In the corner. Some touching here that's going to be taken away. A little bit of double team, and Tiger's going to get control here on the far side. Battle for Mantilla, just getting control of the ball with his quickness. Pass underneath. Nearly got it to Degner. Now Degner get knocked down to the ground. Nothing called. Play goes on and on the run here. Good head ball to clear out of trouble. And a flick back. Enright's going to pass that ball back. This one cleared away. Oh, a missed pass there, and that's going to go out beyond the reach of Enright. This will be a throw-in for the Tigers. Nick Wheeler to throw in. Subs coming in. Minute time. Going down here for Herscher. Still a lot of time left in this one. Looking for the equalizer. 2-1. Waterloo Gibault looking for the championship, and Herscher trying to tie it up. Far side, this will roll and go out. It should be a, is it a corner?
Looks like Schwarzkopf is taking the ball out that way, yeah.
Akunis will take the corner, and it'll come from the back. A short bubble step in, shot put on, that one too high and long, too far. Hard to say if that was a good idea or not to have Trenton Cruz come up from the back and take it off the corner
one
there.
One thing I noticed, one thing, is that the Gibault did not step up. They actually stayed there without trying to capture the team off sides.
Well, battle midfield. This one sent to the right side. Touch underneath, deflected, and good job defensively. Battle, it comes back the other way. Hawks trying to make a move. Enright trying to pull a fake. Cuts back, gets tripped up and taken down. There was contact, no doubt about it. Colin Lund caught his legs as he tried to make the cut to the inside.
There you go, folks. Watch.
You can see that he put a fake on him, but then he cut the ball, he touched the ball to cut back inside, and that's where
and
there was contact.
Trip.
Yep,
that was the trip right there.
And guess who's gonna take this? Frank Mantilla.
Who else would you want?
And they're asking for the wall to go back a little bit. Keep an eye on Degner, keep an eye on Reinholz. Actually, I don't see Reinholz, he's back on defense. Mantilla going to send this up here. It's curling. Backside and headed out. And chipped back in. A low kick in there, but Tiger's able to clear the ball away and coming up the far side here. Still kept alive past the middle. Now working from the middle. This one's going to be crossed towards the top. Head ball, loose. Chance. Oh, and it goes over the bar.
Too excited. Too excited for sure. Did not set properly on that one.
Hall had his chance. Look at Hall. He won the ball and the defender, and it was right there, and he just got too much underneath it.
Well, I got to tell you, Rusty, the Tigers have had their chances to take the lead or even tie and take their lead. They just have not put it together.
Approaching the 76th minute here. Still 2-1. Hawks in front. Touch here brought down. Tigers going to try to send it over the near side. Head ball back the other way. Enright and chase, and battle four goes out, and it's going to be a throw-in. He picked the ball up. Did he catch it over the line? I think he caught it on the line.
Whoa.
That should be a, if he caught it on the line, then that'd be a problem. And now they threw the ball in.
Here you go. Watch this. It was off
red.
It was off red.
Yeah, but he picked up the ball thinking it was their ball, and
exactly.
It wasn't.
Exactly. That's all he did.
I think we got confused with the line just as much as anybody else. Just our camera guy doing a great job. This one going to the far side, and boy, that ball had a chance there.
That's funny, Rusty. We're hearing the Tiger fans right in front of us, and they've got basically two sections here in front. And I stand up and I look to the other side, and we really didn't notice. But the Hawks got three sections and a whole standing unit down on the other end.
I think it was Ostrowski that had the chance on that when they went by the post. Then he was talking to the referee about it. But nothing was made after that situation. I think he might have been saying it was deflected on that last kick. Final few minutes here, up to 77th minute. This one trapped down, good move. Looking for some help back to the middle. Hawks are back defensively, except for one guy playing up front here. That's Mantilla. Looking for some help. Mantilla gonna dribble the ball around. And now he's going to drop it off with some help coming from the weak side. Franceschi back to Mantilla. They're taking some time off the clock. Mantilla had the ball tackled away, and they're going to call a foul here. And that foul is going to be on Zach Simmons. Referee wants him to set the ball down and let's go. And they're just going to touch it short. Send it over the far side. I mean, everybody's packed in for the Tigers when they should be marked up. This one sent down the line and will bounce its way out on the far side. Howard wants the ball back quickly, gets a new ball right into play. 78th minute here. And Howard, there have been some substitutions going on here. Now they stop the clock on the substitutions. Matt Reeb making some subs here, trying to take a couple seconds off the clock. Referee has the discretion to stop the clock in this situation.
They are making adjustment to the clock, though. Referee is going over.
Well, I think they may make an adjustment on it because he's tried to stop the clock earlier. And now the referee is going over and talking to the bench, Matt Reeb over there.
Still at 2:38. I don't quite get how much time
you can make the subs, but if he's doing it purposely to stall the time, that's where some questioning comes into play. But however, the referee can stop the clock on that too. That's been brought up under discussion over the last couple of years. But referee does have the discretion to stop the clock if this continues, where if they keep bringing subs in. Are we ready here? I think we are for the goal kick. Howard will send this up. Head ball. Tiger's going to send this forward directly. Trying to set up to the far side. I'm going to send this inside. Kicked away. Good job by the Hawks here. I'm keeping it alive. And Hawks able to get control of this. Play goes on.
Frank Mafia there.
Boy, is that Mantilla again getting control? And just lofts the ball out. Howard's going to pick it up, and he's going to punt it away. Good kick with a high kick. Send it out. A little bit of a collision there. Play continues to go on. And it's going to roll to the far side, sent down the line, and this is going to stay in. Coming up to the 79th minute of play here. Final 2 minutes. Herscher trying to get the equalizer, and Waterloo Gibault looking for a state championship. Now on the far side. This one kicked away again. A little bit of collision back there. Simmons thought he was fouled, no call. And the Hawks lofting it back on the end of the Tiger side. Taking a few more seconds off the clock. And now the Tigers are taking a substitution.
The referee is going over to the desk.
Well, it's interesting. The Tigers had a man standing over there. So now he stops the clock again. I don't see anything more than a Tigers player over there. Looks like Sam Pakunas, if he's considered on the field, which I think he is. Yeah, he's on the field.
They moved it up 6 seconds. From 133, they pushed it to 139.
It's interesting because I don't see a double sub here. It's just... Now conversations are being made. Referee is talking to the bench and Matt Reeb. I think now we're okay with what's going on. They're still discussing on the table now.
We're still at 139, folks.
Now they're going to adjust the clock. We know that. So the question is, what are they adjusting clock to? Now, it might have something to do with the previous substitution situation, but I thought they adjusted that before, but now they're going to put more time on the clock once they can do that upstairs.
Well, they did from 133. Now they put it 139. Now they're going to make it to anyone's guess right now. No, they dropped it to 125. Okay, so there was 14 seconds taken off.
Okay, well, we know there's 85 seconds left.
Okay.
Ball That's thrown it. In for the Tigers. As we're approaching the 80th minute, got a collision here, and it's going to be a foul, and the Tigers are going to take it. And Sessions going to kick a low grounder to the weak, to the far side of the field. What an idea that
he's
is.
He's good.
That's Mantilla that took that kick.
Oh, gosh. He knew how to click the clock time. Well, we're under 1 minute here, folks.
And then in the 80th minute, and Tigers time to tie it up, getting very, very, very late. And the Hawks trying to kick the ball back the other way. This one sent in to Howard. Howard quickly up, going to try to punt this away. Sent forward, nice high kick to the top of the box. Head ball, Gregson comes up and gets it. That's one of the longest kicks we've seen all weekend.
And they're going to return it.
Sent back down, mainly the Tigers staying back defensively. I should say the Hawks are. Tigers trying to push. Final 15 seconds coming up, maybe one more good opportunity. This one kicked away.
There we go.
Final 10 seconds coming up here. This one thrown in the box, head ball out. Could there be a shot put on in the final second here? Nope, it's cleared away, and that's it.
They are the champions.
The Hawks come away with the state championship, the first one for Matt Reeb, the fourth one in the last 10 years here for Waterloo Gibault, and the hard-fighting Herscher Tigers will come away with second place. I'll tell you, we were treated to an outstanding game here tonight.
Absolutely. It was delightful. Really nice.
Here's the Tigers' first goal off Gregson, the rebound. put right in. That was the early lead for Herscher. And then the Mantilla flick, head ball goal here by Degener. And this one put in by Ryan Holtz on the free kick, the decisive goal. And that's the goal scoring here tonight. And I'll tell you, both these teams played hard out here. But the Hawks, you know, come away with the big win, the championship trophy. You got to hand it off to the way Waterloo Gibault played and Herscher for that matter.
You know, I hope back home, folks, you really enjoyed this game the way Rusty and I have up here. It was a lot of fun. We had a great weekend here. Hope you enjoyed the earlier game also. And don't forget, we're going to see you guys next weekend.
Yep, should remind everybody, the Class 2A, Class 3A semifinals and finals will be at Hoffman Estates High School if you're planning to go out there. If not, you can catch us right here on IHSA TV next weekend. The 2A, 11 and 1 o'clock. The 3A will be at 5 and 7 o'clock on Friday. Those will be the semifinals, the state finals, third place and championship for 2A, 11 and 1 on Saturday. And then the third place and championship for 3A will be at 5 and 7 o'clock on Saturday night. So
hey, I want to do one thank out out there to our cameraman who stuck it out all weekend in that freezing cold. Jess, you did a fantastic job out there. And to our producer, Ryan, hey, great job, guys. We'll see you next weekend.
And you too, Ron. Great job.
You too,
and,
Rusty.
Have yourself a safe rest of the weekend. Final score once again, Waterloo Gibault, state champions. They win over Herscher by a score of 2-1. For everybody here, Ron, myself, Rusty Silber, medal presentation coming up. You've been watching the IHSA TV network.
Urbana University High School. And Beth Salzer, the IHSA administrator, and the administrator responsible for boys soccer. Assistant Principal Brett Elliott. Athletic Director Kurt Schlake. Trainer Laura Retke. Head Coach Alan High. Assistant Coach Philip Peacock. Assistant Coach Travis Yookman. Manager TJ Fuller. Manager Nick Goodrich. Double zero, Wes Nelson. Woo-hoo! Number one, Joe Galis. Number two, Mitchell Schwarzkopf. Number three, Jager Erickson. Number four, Colin Lund. Number five, Sam Pedagunas. Number six, Nick Wheeler. Number seven, Nathan O'Connor. Number eight, Kevin Hughes. Number nine, Dustin Love. Number 10, Brody Ryan. Number 12, Colton Walter. Number 13, Zach Goodrich. Number 14, Zach Simmons. Number 17, Robert Fry. Number 18, Travis Ostrowski. Number 20, Chase Dennis. Number 21, Wade Pritchard. Number 22, Jim Stewart. Number 25, Sam Hall. Number 26, Cruz Letke. Number 67, Leighton Howard. Assistant coach Tim Reed. Assistant coach Darren Heidrich. Assistant coach Tyson Coffey. Manager Kendra Davis. Manager Lucas Eplin. Number zero, Austin Gregson. Number two, Tyler Enright. Number three, Nick Rao. Number four, Ethan Shields. Number five, Jack Blamey. Number six, Jacob Bozer. Number seven, Christian Kohler. Number eight, Jarrett Laurent. number 9, Zach Eplin. Number 10, Mitch Mayer. Number 11, Jack Reeder. Correction, number 11 is Jake Reeder. Number 12, Wes Degner. Number 13, Frank Mantilla. Number 14, Tom Franciscan. Number 11, Dylan McCoy. Number 15, Dylan McCoy. Number 16, Andrew Reinholz. Number 17, Zach Leader. Number 18, Matt Meath. Number 19, Dalton Skase. Number 20, Caleb Schilling. Number 21, Grant Gardner. And number 23, Evan Wessel. Will Coach High and captains from Herscher High School please step forward to receive the second place trophy? Thank you.